don't want to go past 1:30. Let's be done by 1:30. So members, you can start. I think we have the quorum. So before you or on the projector there, we have the agenda, opening prayer, item number 10, closing remarks and prayer. Should we change? Should we, anyone propose to adopt the agenda, or is something we need to add or meet? I'm not seeing A or B, the longer part of the meeting, so if you think that there's anything you want, A or B, so we can have it there. Else?
Why don't we finish? Why don't we end with the minutes? Because I see Broughton hosting 8 and 9. We'll be interchanging. So we can do the minutes, then we do the minutes. Because I guess that was the reason.
So the. So I think we can have review of previous. Actually, should it be action point? Action points last. Mm-hmm. We review, then action point. So that means we're going to have item number 9 should move to number 7. Mm-hmm. Then number 8 should be review of minutes, and number 9 action point, action report. Thank you so much. I want to ensure that at least all the people, the vision of ICT policy, who is going to talk about that? Nobody? ICT policy. Maybe we can talk about it if it's, I think I've not yet started working on that. Yeah, we can see what to discuss about it. I know someone who can come up with the policy. Can I have someone propose that we adopt the agenda?
I propose that we adopt
seconded,
as amended,
then seconded by nobody. Yes. Mr. Kenya, maybe give us an opening prayer.
Sure.
Thank you so much. Much. Item number 2, attendance, recording of attendance, which you have done. But other members come, then they'll be able to register the attendance. Communication from the chair and the reactions, it's been combined. Item number 3. Hopefully, but the information I have actually is she's our acting dean. The dean is on leave. So Professor Jose, she's acting as the dean right now, and the information I have is they're having a meeting, a search committee meeting, because two of my members of staff from the department, they have gone for further studies, so they're giving us one person to come and help us next semester. So the dean and myself are supposed to be in that meeting, but I'm being represented by my colleague, so I believe that she's attending the search committee meeting. I pray to God that I'll be able to communicate what is expected. Member, thank you so much for coming and also for honoring this meeting, this very important meeting. This meeting actually is very important because, as you know, ICT is a core of any organization. So in reality, without ICT, this university may not survive for long, actually. I'm happy that before us we can see the e-learning facility, it's running. And actually the Vice Chancellor acknowledged the ICT committee. They have put in to have this e-learning facility up and running. But also we want to thank the university for all the support, because the university has really injected a lot of money. And I'm glad to report to you that it's only UCU with such facility in Uganda, if not East Africa. So we have to look for a way of using this facility, members, of encouraging members to use this facility. Today I was coming in, I whispered to nobody and the manager, UIS, I'm writing a proposal to start forensic science here at UCU. About 2 weeks ago, 2 months ago, I was in India and Turkey, Interpol. We are trying to see how we can bring forensic science in Uganda. I think in the whole of East Africa, there's no forensic science. And forensic science is really wide. I had an opportunity where I visited. They are proposing it, actually. They are proposing it, but also we need to move fast, actually, I think, them. But in terms of facilities and equipment, we seem to be far much better than them, actually. Because I had an opportunity where I went to see what we can borrow from them. The truth is we don't have the manpower here, and I believe that with this facility, we can collaborate with them, they can have lectures, then students will be able to attend classes. Some of the courses actually I'm planning to have, and I'm in touch with them, is the forensic accounting and the fraud investigation. Because we believe when we start with that, we'll be able to set up the facility. And we don't have any expert here for forensic accounting. So with this facility, they'll be able to train from Turkey, and then we'll be able to attain classes to this year. So we believe that if we start with this facility, we shall be able to do quite a lot of things. I've already alerted my master's for training. I've taken the program to Mbale, MIT, because in the whole Eastern region, there is no master's in IT computer science, and the demand is really high in the Eastern region. So we are starting MIT Mbale, and we shall be using this facility to conduct classes teach students in Mbale. So I want to thank you members because that's the initiative started from this committee. It went to the management, they approved it. I want to thank you for all the effort. Last time we had also a meeting in the guide website, something is being done. If you look at the website, there's quite a lot of improvement. This meeting, I had a meeting with the Edwin, trying to see how we can publicize our new programs. One of the new programs under my department is called Bachelor of Science in Electronics and the Communication Engineering. It's not yet known, so I've told Edwin to ensure that we upload that program on our website. Even at our program, we have revised the BSIT. We have really revised it to meet the needs of the community. We have three specializations, oil and gas informatics, agriculture informatics, and the health informatics. All of these are under BSIT, but people are not aware. So I've told Edwin to ensure that we upload all this in our website. The same with the computer science, we have revised it, the specialization with e-space, artificial intelligence. So we're going to upload all these new programs on our website so that people can get to know exactly what we're offering. So as you know, members, that we're supposed to have at least one meeting every semester. So ever since the semester began, we've not had any meeting. So that's why we're here, trying to see how we can move forward. Because this committee reports directly to management, so whatever we discuss, whatever we agree, we normally communicate to management, and then management can advise accordingly. So one of the things we need to talk about this afternoon, is about the status of the labs at campus, which we are going to talk about, it, and I think item number 6. Because for next semester, May semester, we need to ensure that students labs are set up, they are up and running, and they can help our students. So, members, thank you so much for coming. Briefly, that we're supposed to communicate. Other thing we're supposed to communicate is in regard for item number 7, where we have given an opportunity to host the next UCC conference. I will go talk about that and elaborate it more. So, members, thank you so much for coming. Briefly, that is some reaction from the communication. Thank you so much. I think we know ourselves. Do we need to introduce ourselves? Yeah, I think we know each other. I don't know whether she knows me. Same battery challenge with you.
But the program is introduced by names, but surely, think it is one thing we need to think about. I think I don't want to call it our marketing strategies, but exactly our content. People do not know what happens in UC, especially the IT courses. I myself, if you ask me what is the content of IT, I did computer science personally, but I would not advise someone who comes to ask me the content of the course and then they say, okay, where can I read details of the course? I think our website, it is one thing that needs much more effort. So that data is not kept to ourselves. The content in the curriculum, I wonder, why can't it be posted on our website?
I'll respond to that.
Thank you. Most of those, especially those science courses, really, our applicants, they be few and they need details about the program, then you can't tell what is this, the difference between this and this, the benefits of doing the course, and then they want details. They say they usually, when they go to the website, they click under the website, they really can't find details of the program. So it is a concern actually from now admission side. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Would you also ask us the chance communication about the courses? Wouldn't I be part, but we couldn't run as many as possible. But what we do besides the handbags, we are trying to really maximize the social media, like WhatsApp messages. So doctor, if you could share maybe those numerous courses with me, we could design something besides the website for social media. What I do website, if they have been approved admissions, they have some control rights on the website for putting their admissions related information. They have someone called Esther.
And who currently left?
Well, I know they're leaving, but Krista did ask and she was given. They have someone who places their admissions related information. But yes, for me, if you could share those courses, so the newer courses, they need to be some boost. Since the website, we can design some things for WhatsApp, and we've been trying in that direction.
Okay.
Without going so much in detail, yes, also what she raised. One time was last year, was in very attentive management, where that concern, we made a case for compiling information about UC. We very brief, like maybe for a course, not more than a day, but summarizing key facts. Why this course, maybe bachelor of computing, why this course, what does it cover, what do I become when I do that? So that then we are empowered, some of us maybe speak or who are confronted with questions. When I did that, I was advised to channel as well BBC Academics. I know that Pamela did actually write to different people, heads, and deans, asking for that, process that from their curriculum. If we have it, then the idea would be to share it with a different, maybe all of us, because you can do business, they are asking you engineering to build our capacities in the experience. Yes, by the website, yes, we've been working on this one, and we're going to launch it on the 24th next month.
That will be good.
Yes, it's more or less ready, but we consulted the feedback was we should maybe do it so quietly. The photo was given by BBCDR and BC because there's a council meeting there. And we have the chair council. And that council meeting is in the 5 days, like in the
Thank you so much for that information. Yes, Mr. Kenya.
It would have been appropriate to look at the new site because we had reviewed something the last meeting that we had. So I don't know. I think it did the CIC lose its hold on that? I think is one question I'm wondering. But also just about the programs. Personally, I don't see Lydia's concern. Or the general concern of people accessing our info changing much if we don't change how we work. Because this is inherent in how we think and work. It is not about the system because we have the technology. Everything is available. We have the people. The people are just not sure what to do. Even you're talking about Krista, she knows what she's probably doing from her end, but the final delivery isn't there. And then our monitoring and evaluation is very poor. You were there, I think, in the strategic planning meeting, at the RIDA, yes. Our monitoring and evaluation is so poor. So for me, I can guarantee a year later, we can meet, and after whatever you've done, we still have the same problem. The problem for me comes from, now I'm glad you're here, it comes from you, the faculties, if you don't, because we get a program, we run it, but we don't own it. The head of department, the dean, does not own it, doesn't pretty much care, it's, as long as it's, is the information there, is something there, good, no problem, that's okay. No, we haven't picked actually UCU, its programs, and owned them, and made them a reality. I mean, you're talking about some fantastic stuff about forensic accounting and so on. Already there should be something buzzing. You should have written an article about it, how it's going to help. It should be on their website. You should have talked to the community about it. You should have invited members of the community to discuss it. No one is owning anything. Everybody's busy running around and doing other things than what's important. What's important is our product. And what we've failed to do is manage this product well. And that comes to you, Michael, because now you are the crux of this. For you, your job is to ensure that all facets are working in tandem. Research, our research is all hidden. When I came in, the first thing I said, please, could I have your research? The key thing is, we are like a factory that does not have a clue about its product. We don't. We can't even, if you ask, now you're talking about profiles and biodata. The profiles and biodata should be attached to research. That's why in that strategic planning meeting I insisted we must have a research information system. Because what that will do, it will help us profile our researchers.
True.
And it will be an added point for you. Mike, that will be huge for you. Because if you have a university and you're, because one, our products, our graduates are key, but also our research. Those are two key things that we do. Our graduates, and then the graduation rate should be good and up, and that should be something to behold, and our research. They should both be up there in equal measure. So for me, I think Lydia will pose the same question and say people are so confused, they couldn't apply, we lost an applicant, because no one has actually taken to own the things that we do. Things are just there, so we talk about a program, the information is supposed to be there, but you see she's telling you we followed all possible links and we couldn't get to what we wanted. And so the question is, it begs more questions, who is responsible? Michael may have an answer, and you may find that actually people look at Michael and say, Mark, you're the marketing person, but is it Michael's really job to do that? It isn't. Let me give an example as to just to emphasize what I'm saying. E-learning. the idea of e-learning started in the idea was moved, I think, in 2006. Now, okay, thank you. I think the ICT started something, testing something. Then the UIS started testing something. Now, everyone thought it was the UIS's business. I insisted, I kept saying, it is not the UIS's business to run e-learning. They kept just saying, UIS, do you have the platform? So in 2008, Moodle was installed. And then I said, now what? I said, now what? It's installed, now what? And until last year or the other year, did something actually, I said, the department that is responsible, the academics, must own it. Until they did, have we moved to this point. With this, what you're talking about, people just understanding UCU, getting the website to do what it's supposed to do, will not work until someone owns it. And that comes from partly the faculties. You need to empower. We have staff who don't work as well as they should. We have admins. What do they do? For me, I ask that question. Apart from just answering some phone calls and receiving marks here, distributing this, what else do they do? They have to be empowered to own that information for you. They have to be the kingpins, the people who are there. If you were a dean, that admin assistant should be your best worker. But we don't even know how to get the most out of such people. We don't. That person should make the faculty tick. Any information should be up there by that person. If it's not there, it should be a personal crusade that it's there. If you don't have such people, fire those guys. They're useless. I'm telling you. Get people who can work, people who understand why they're there. Anything to do with the faculty, any information should be coming from you require. You call them and they can't get rid of them. They're useless. We need to get to that point whereby we demand, we have KPIs, and we demand. Information that is there must be there. That admin already should be demanding an article from you. Work information about this new course. It should be up there and known, so that when you get the information, it's up there, it is proper, anyone can get it, people can apply online. Everything is kind of seamless because you have a good team here. The people out there, they're just happy to, oh, really? Ah, UIS, no. Krista, no. Michael, marketing, what is that? I mean, it starts with the person, the core, faculties. Take charge. When you take charge, things will move, I can guarantee. Things will move. Even Michael's work would have been made easier. His job is just to oversee and ensure that things are working the way they should.
That's true.
I'm telling you.
Thank you, Mr. Bukinya, for those advice. I do agree with you 100%. And I think it could be that that was not outside of this committee. Because this is... But also it can be one of our recommendations to management.
We need something very practical, because if you've seen School of Medicine, Dr. Ned has really been out there for his thing to see that it really takes off and it has the numbers. Because you'll find that he will even have more than the 50 he's anticipating to have as prospective applicants at a certain point in time. But as science and technology, we have people who have your land, all the people in first have masters. We need to add more value to our students, that it's not only about them waiting for a job, but are they creative? Are they thinking outside the box? I recently called someone in agriculture. I took almost a week without getting information. On universities in the UK and Europe, you just check master's in IT. You're able to do this. This is the course content. This is how long it can take you.
Exactly.
I mean, I don't need even to call a recruiter. I don't need.
Exactly.
Yes. If you need more information about this, please contact Dr. Sembatia. But I literally cannot even know how long a BSIT program can take.
Exactly.
I don't know the course load.
Honestly.
I don't know the grading point. Really?
I don't know that. And then we want students for the course. And they are coming, but we can't give them information. It's embarrassing. Actually, someone posted on our page and said, wow. We actually ran to the curriculum books, and that day we couldn't even find the curriculum book. It was terrible. For that very specific course I've talked about.
The recruiter will always respond in time. I would like to know this. 5 minutes, the information is given to you. It doesn't need rocket science to do something.
I do agree with you. Even a small million tongue, that's a better response. I think there's something you need to put in order. Because the information they have, the curriculum don't belong to faculty. That's why it belongs to the office of the UGA. If anyone asks for their curriculum, the fact that I give that curriculum, that's what I'm going to analyze. Because the curriculum belongs to the office of the UGA.
But faculties are under DVCAA.
That's why when we submit the curriculum, we provide that experience. When you say there's no document, we submit the curriculum, but soft copy and then copy. Have all that document.
Okay.
But what we need to do, as department and faculty, I do agree with you, that we need to, and I think the work of ICT committee,
yes.
We need to ensure that we get this information from all department and faculty, and then incorporate our website, so that the information is available. But again, we are not supposed to put the whole document.
No, you can't put a whole document. There is a time we had a summary. And even those flyers, there are flyers that come from different departments.
Matthew.
I could think those flyers could be posted
Matthew.
On our website.
Flyer.
Yes, we have a few flyers from a few faculties that have taken a step about a program. If those flyers, because usually they give a few highlights about the program, they're just one page or half actually, if they could also go onto our website. Because we are in a .com era, people. Even when they are seated at the reception, they are checking on your website, the course they've come to apply for. And then after checking and there is nothing, then they come to you. I was actually even going through your website, but I'm not seeing the course I want to apply for. You see?
In fact, today morning I've done all of this and I gave it to a point to you.
Oh.
After realizing that, because one of my relatives applied here from the Katusaya, we got an admission with the admission in PAP something, at the copy. So when I opened that at the copy, my new program electronics was not there.
Yes.
So I immediately called the priest. I had to go to the admission and said, people, my office, my program is not here. Then they told me, we're still using the old PAP.
Imagine. Imagine.
So you see, and you're right.
Even as we advertised the last month, actually. But even me, I depend on information from Krista.
Oh,
like, I don't know, really, I can't have everything like offered. I hope maybe it was in that one.
Yeah, so for Krista, we paid for that information, and they provided all the information for the new country, for the new program. Because we have a new program, we provide our programs, and I provided all that information to Krista. That's what I was wondering.
Well, for me, the lesson I think, Doctor, is even when we do that, we should be putting, like what you are saying, DVCAA. We shouldn't let him be there. Like now, because you try to move around, you're able to observe something.
Meaning, hadn't you sit and think things are moving? I'm glad I'm hearing this from here.
So, I think we need to come up with a format. Maybe we can have an ICT committee. We can identify the past and the faculty. Provide the faculty to different faculties.
Okay.
Let all the faculties provide, if you can agree, provide this information. And this information will upload it.
Actually, even besides that, you see what Bukenya here said. For instance, that information of Christian admission is information. Because it encompasses the whole university, even faculty should be having those things there. People should be asking that, give us. So that when people ask you, say, no, actually, our ITUC is here number 45 among our courses at that level because it has you. Now even that should be noticed, like it would only point is noticed earlier.
That's why I was surprised that she called the faculty and said they don't know the program.
Yes.
And
they're
telling you,
we take things for granted. Someone has been assistant and they think their role
is speak call.
Yes. I'm telling you.
You're right.
Because even
just
then you'll
verify
that they would.
So
because as you admit, the details of the course you should be referring us. You go to your faculty, they
for
tell you
details.
When is it coming.
You would have a verified university, you'd be amazed.
And
they just think, or maybe they just really.
I think people just need to put in some little effort. Last semester, social sciences had a problem. No, last year. Their numbers had gone really very low. We had to go and meet them. And we agreed, let marketing be a part and parcel
of
what you're doing. And I think the dean then put in some effort. Recently I see a banner at the entrance of the gate. I am surprised that their numbers are picked up. Somehow she started communicating with their students, having interactions with, I think, the old students. And now social sciences, that this coming admission, I think they are getting almost 30%. And last year they had the least. New programs and they are catching up. Social sciences that had died, social work and social administration, I think last year they had like 20. Now we already have 100 plus applicants. So the faculty has a lot to play in this. And the lady has just, I think she did this last semester of January.
And you don't stop doing it.
She doesn't stop.
It comes from that dean, the head of the departments, that was what that means, who makes things tick here.
Because marketing a service is not like
sugar.
That someone will only undertake tea. A service, you must add a lot of value to it in order to get enough of the customers.
That's
and
true.
As you know, there are very many institutions. A parent would just be there and they're like, there's this institute called something Makerere. I'm like, okay, I can take my child to this
is nice.
Called Makerere. Whether it's the real Makerere or the not, they don't care.
So this is the sample that I'm designing at the same time this one for the three program.
People need to hear that, you know.
We are going to partner with Albert University, Georgia, US. And actually, this facility is going to help us because there are a number of questions that actually don't have experts here. So the guys in Georgia will be able to teach our students using this facility.
Okay.
There it is moving.
Thank you.
is e-learning.
People comment about literally everything.
I'm telling you, we don't make, I think we need to tell whatever. You'll fix it. But you have to be, if my fellow librarians laugh at me, they'll really laugh, they'll never stop teasing me. I can't accept that.
Mark.
I'm telling you. Because I tease them. If I see that they're slight, I tease them. Say, what nonsense is this?
Say the answer.
See what Kara is doing now. Fingertips. Can't
write
finger.
Actually, it's one of the challenges we're facing.
I was in that meeting, this was not a because the fathers were having information, but we need the proxy. Where that person is going to the information, the website. I don't know if marketing was at Black, where we provide the information, you come to the department, you go to that information, before it's uploaded.
This is the e-learning platform. Make a e-learning platform.
This is a website.
This is
a
UC website.
This is a UC website.
This one must be the e-learning mark, isn't it?
That's the e-learning homepage.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
But could we change? Could we change fingertips to fingertips?
You're ballast. Imagine someone from outside, and this is UCU. The center of excellence.
Well, by the way, if you don't believe in that, things will always be like this. And then you have to believe that you're the best point. So,
you're capturing a mistake. You know, that's what people do. They capture like that and they start trending with it. That would also work.
Who updates the library website?
Sorry?
Who works on the library website?
NAFIA. You're using UCU. It's NAFIA.
This is good. Sorry, it's up to date.
Fairly.
Our main website, we should also go at it
for. No, well, not entirely, because there's so much.
Yes, okay. I was going to share that information.
I was just wondering, the people that design the website, what would their benchmark in university be? Because what we tell you what they say, because there are now types of websites, we have the marketing website, we have that website. And most people have been marketing, benchmarking from marketing website to the
website. This committee chair, sometime last year, like you say, they picked interest here. There is a presentation that admissions made, and UIS also tried. There are some few websites that people looked at. A lot of them were failed, but yes, there were some, and a presentation was made to this committee, which I think they passed, and then UIS was guided, among others, by
so, the remember the few things, especially remember one week or two, to have another.
You may, it is this website of ours, /new. Yes.
Oh,
not everyone is accessing it now, but it's the same /new.
By the time you have been
we We shared with the heads and deans, asking them for their comment, which...
I think it's much better. Mm-hmm. But also, when I was in Kaki, we work with the YS actually, we tried to think into our system, what we say, and we showed it actually very, very easy.
Sorry?
We bought it and we put whatever we want, so security.
Mm-hmm. Maybe that is now technically.
It's technical.
Nobody is here to.
We can advise and see how that
new. How comes I?
You see you
slash.
Slash you.
Mm-hmm. What slash new?
Forward. Yeah. The same login, then forward slash new.
I've sent you the.
Yeah, I've seen it. Edwin could be working on it. Sometimes they. I think when they're working on it, it could be one, but that's.
I've ever accessed it. Members, we nobody's trying to open something.
Trying to connect.
So that we can agree. Because normally what I normally see on the website, it's not the whole curriculum, but we have the structures.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Which actually have done there to see what you're supposed to cover semester one, mm-hmm. semester two, semester three. Mm-hmm.
You maximize.
But what I've done actually, I've given a copy to Joseph, also put up another copy.
Okay.
I've also tried to print the first page of the program, and I put it there on the first page. But also had a copy, Joseph told me the main codes.
The reception. That would be very helpful. That would be very helpful.
So this is the transfer.
As an idea. That's very helpful.
So, where are the list of the lectures? I can see.
We have elective
questions.
They're called elective one, elective two.
There has to be a list from where you choose.
Ah, okay.
Well, I'm looking for the list.
No, it's not here.
That's what I had to pick it from the curriculum and then bring it here. Mm-hmm. But I think what's important, maybe the department in fact are not aware what they're supposed to provide. Because for them, they think that they submitted the curriculum to the DVO official, that's all.
And so that's, yeah, really? You see, now that's the point.
I think we, maybe if there is a way this committee could send it as a recommendation, we use this sample.
Yeah, this sample, yes.
It can be sent to every faculty that may develop such an instrument for every course, and we post it on our website as one of the action points for every faculty.
Mm. Okay.
It would really do wonders for admissions. pull out a few of those things, but somehow, like you say, people don't, they don't follow up mentoring and evaluation is.
Yeah, that's true. So I think that's going to be action point immediately after here.
Thank you.
I'm going to send the all things with the samples so that you can provide the your office or the Edwin.
We need a copy and then of course to Edwin.
To Edwin,
exactly.
For uploading it. Because actually, me, the reason why I did this, I took since I'm not aware. That's why I said, oh, I need to do something.
So. And in reality, they come and ask if I'm to do this course. And you know, once a student faces bias, they feel, hey, this course that no one knows about, they definitely make their mind and choose another course on. They just put a second choice and say, okay, give me this one. Yet they may probably came with something in their minds.
But also, one of the whistleblowers, I got a whistleblower for the permission to tell
them
that the student came wanted to do this IT.
Mm.
But the person actually who received that student. Why don't you go to the
It's a continuous struggle.
That's not good.
So let me go to, I think,
thank you for that observation.
The disaster recovery system was done in two phases. The first phase was completed. We purchased storage and it was configured for replication. The storage that's supposed to be our primary storage here and the one that's supposed to be the recovery storage and our configured for replication. So that was done. Now phase two is what we are on. That would involve buying the computers with the computing power to host the applications and run the whole disaster recovery application. That has not been done yet, but we are waiting for VC to sign to approve the purchase of the servers. Once he's back, I think it's a matter of all the documentation was done, revised, so it's now up to him. We just need his signature and then we shall order for the servers. Some time back he also requested us to, because the cost is a bit high, he requested us to contact Renew and see if there is a... We had a meeting with Renew, we discussed and we agreed that we just go on with the original architecture. It was the best. We just have to... There is another... We can do co-location where we host, our servers actually sit in Renew.
Which servers?
It would be easier that way.
Which ones?
The primary now, the production.
Production
servers? Yes. Then we can either put the backup servers either in Kampala campus or one other, or here. We can have some servers here and basically some servers at Renew. But we saw the advantages with that, especially with linking and connectivity. But there is a contract, of course, that we have to draft that is going through some revisions. The last revision came in from the legal office, and now also UIS submitted some revision because we noticed Renew had omitted some section where they need to be. Take full control of the security of the servers. So there are some revisions going on within this agreement of co-location. But that, if VC comes and, for example, signs off our purchase for the servers, the implementation can go on. We can configure the whole solution here. This co-location can come up later when the contract is signed. But the actual implementation of the disaster recovery solution will go on as soon as VC signs off.
So it's basically phase two, and it's going on. Yeah, that is the status with the disaster recovery system. Unless there are any other reactions. Yes.
Staffing?
Yes, they are actually.
Response time, all those elements.
They are actually hosting similar systems for very other big companies here.
Okay.
They are actually good.
I think the capacity is very good, but they are catching for it. What do you think about
it? Better?
The principle is that the old government,
it has a lot to do with the capacity and future of rent.
Yes.
Then there's one thing I wanted to share with this committee. I shared with the chairperson.
And I think it's a thing, but we can discuss it here. In regard to our mailing system.
Yes.
Yeah, because it's good and it's been running for several times. But most of the universities now are.
Which system are we talking about?
This.
Zimbla.
Like this.
Yeah, the Zimbla. Because it came to me, the time it crashed, actually, I was away.
Yeah,
the Zimbla. The time it crashed, I was away. Because they, we have been using this for previous, I think the last 10 years.
Yes.
I have a proposal. And my proposal is to move out from Zimbla. about 8 years ago, Mbarara University had a similar issue. I think they were using Zimbla, crashing, this and that. And then it came up with outsourced, and I was on the committee. That actually proposed to move out from Zimbla and then to use the Google app for universities. Now, Google app for universities has been there for the previous 10 years or so. And the number of universities that have been using Google app for emails, Mbarara University is using it. Now Uganda Math has joined, I think Makerere has joined, NYU has joined. About powerful universities in the US, many of them are now using Google app. And it provides a number of an interesting service.
Sure.
So, and it's cheaper. And actually, about 5 years ago, it was free. But because now it's maintenance, whatever, now I put some fee. I want to propose, I don't know whether we can have a committee to investigate the Google app and see whether we can now move away from Zimbabwe to Google app. So I don't know whether this committee can propose, set up a committee to look into that.
Of accepting. The scripture recommends.
That's the way to go because considering
it could operable, crash for over 2 weeks and still create dilemmas, then if the Google app can give us a more robust, reliable platform, then we should be agreeing in principle. We could move on. Not with the Google app, but I think if it's
good,
that good, why not?
But I think in any sense,
this committee should be recommending, which for me I would support.
So it should be that the committee should write to
recommend to the management.
Yeah,
that the management.
It could be having some idea.
Yes, actually, the last time we need to crash, I have my friend who works also in CIT in Makerere. She called me and told me, how dare you still be about? She told me, oh, that is very terrible. You risk, and the fact that it has started crashing, beware that soon it will crash again. I couldn't believe it. And then she's the one who also proposed to me that I'm saying, oh, she said she's perfect.
If she's really perfect, that's why now you guys might be a provider for the encryption. It's really good, actually. What we can do, we can propose, you know, if management allows.
Yes.
We can have a community benchmark from Barra, Ghana Mata University, to really see what happens.
I have another question. Is it the job of management to recommend this change?
I think this committee has powers.
But yes, because I think for me, I'm glad you brought it up. I think this committee should tell management about that. Because my people don't have the technical know-how to say yes, go ahead or not. What they're interested in is having
even when you tell them Google
a robust emailing system, right?
Yeah.
So if this committee is saying this, then we task the UIS to explore.
Mm-hmm.
And then when the time is right, the hotel manager, we're going to change our path. Right. Or we can tell management.
Should we come up with a committee?
So basically, you want this committee to look at the Google app and Zimbra and compare, look at the two and say.
Yes.
You can also do the benchmarking, they see how it's working the other side, then go ahead and find out how it. Then, of course, the management may ask about the cost implications. You put also the aspect of price. Then you put them
to the combination of all the
What are the benefits?
But when we talk about benchmarking, it involves going that say costs who will charge the cost.
The university. That's the UIS.
Because
even if you want to.
Do we have to go there?
I don't think it's important.
Do we have to go there? Can we do it here? Can this send. You'll have someone come in to show us.
No, Google has ever been here when it was still free. I think that was in about 2014.
Yes, they're not many years ago.
We have the Google ambassador here, actually. Uh-huh.
Google has ever come here.
But
promoting
Google apps. But if you own a Google, it may could be they're marketing their own product.
They
we want to hear what are the universities that have used it, what are they shared.
Usually that even the management, it gives the management a base to make a decision.
My partner can provide a plan if you want to go to Google, but I'm not allowed to change.
Okay.
My partner can provide a vehicle and
show. Yeah. UIS, can't you facilitate
that? That is noted.
Fuel can be available. Fuel
is available.
Yes.
And probably now, it gets from their department.
So do we have like an IT team in Nkozi, Kampala campus?
Unless we talk to them, then find them.
Otherwise, we might have to go to the main campus.
We have the main campus.
So let's have a committee. Then the committee will plan on that. Where to meet these people, in Nkozi or Kampala campus.
Yes.
Then for Bala, we can have a sort of conversation.
Mm-hmm.
So let's have a committee. The committee can have. Most people
actually
are
doing because and the domain still remains
there. So that means
it still remains Dibu Kenya at UCU.
You're disappointed in your UC.
Yeah.
No, oh, actually, if you benchmark around all universities, CIT in services,
because
you can be amazed.
One thing I show, the fact is, often not the body. In fact, when I went to the country, university, and the one writing the book, those guys now are offering new services. Forensic accounting, forensic medicine, forensic psychology, forensic law, forensic.
Even when they teach you computerized accounting, it isn't much, really.
I went to the cyber defense security, the lab. They told me it costed them some money, but within 2 years, I got it. And right now, they're just making progress. And they are teaching me how to do it. We went to sit there, lab, when we were there. We went to the assistant, and we could do anything. Huh? We went to maybe. We got the algorithm that can generate your card.
Could you tell me that? Do you share that algorithm?
Because now they have cyber defense and then attack. And this is how teach students how do you attack. Now, if you see, you can concentrate on that. And that was only
the problem.
I was shocked. And actually, if you see, you can invest only in this cyber. Today I was reading an article, actually, about the high cyber crime in banking. Mm. They can't say anything because they fear to be, you know.
Of course. So you could hack
very, very well.
Yes.
Because what we need is to get there. They call it the quiet one. I don't know what it they are domain sampling. And once you get it, then you can go into the system. Now, those guys now they have made their way in such a way that they actually protect, they are protected. Now, ECU, when we come here, they are telling what to do. Which is, if you go to ECU and set up this facility, attack on maybe generate 504 Yaka number, go to manager, say, manager, your system is broken. They'll give you a contract to manage that. Go to CD, go to bar. All this is to manage. My friend, let me be the teacher of basic IT.
Not to
this
be.
Is serious, by the way.
Yeah.
So we need I think we send some people outside there to be exposed.
Sure.
So that people need to know what's happening. I want to talk to Dean Law. Right now, the lawyers and the director, they have done nothing in regard to. I went to the lab. I was saying, yeah, this is very interesting, actually. For me, it's just, I feel like I want to discuss it tomorrow. That there's a connection between what you are viewing and your brain.
Wow.
Your brain is a way of
the incident. Yes. I think it has
green things showing up.
Now, in Uganda, it's interesting. Most of the judges, they have not learned forensic science too long. Mm. And some of these cases, they have not.
Still basic law.
So this is big. I said, what? We are one. So we still offer basic science. But that's why actually when we find the IT, we used to have 200, now we have 30, 60. Because we're producing many, but outside there,
that's
a lot of work to do, don't we?
I know. I went to the lab, they are investigating, because the forensic science even goes to security, blood proofs. Now, the Bangladesh, they were fighting with another country, and that university manufactured the blood proofs, billions of money. So when they fought for 10 years, the other enemy, they started firing blades and it would go through. Now they brought back the containment to improve this blade proof with the other blade, so that it cannot.
That's
and they were given $100 million. Now they brought that to, for example, student's lab, and they were giving them an assignment for investigation.
Wow.
And the business is getting. The students are going to graduate with master's and bachelor's, and these guys are going to get money. That's also money.
But
because they should be doing real things like that.
Mm, you know?
Yes. Solving real problems, working with real problems, mm-hmm. and managing because anyway, so this is an area to me, but certainly for example, when you go to study abroad, you actually handle real issues. If it's mechanical engineering, you handle
real stuff. Many.
He told me he had calculated, and most companies were saying they were willing to sponsor people up to like 50 million for that course. Now I can see mine is connected to yours. And actually, when he talked to me, I said, if you start tomorrow, I would be your first candidate. I said, wow, because he was actually giving me a scenario. He said he works in a certain bank. They hired someone just to come and detect how people can come and steal data from their company. And he could do something, and then he went with a password and went and opened a password from another one. He could open an email from there. And when they came back, the ED said, what? So that is how, because if I come on your machine, you don't know what I can do. I can actually come and send anything on my email and I just disappear. I go back and I use the very information.
Mm.
And those are some of the things when we talk about security, really. I looked at how we do things in our environment in UCU. Even with my arms open, I leave my door open, then you step out, you come, you start from where you've ended from. Probably someone could have come in and registered a student and who tracks to know that probably someone was here and did something wrong. Really, franchise accounting is
it happened not to my page, it happened one of our secretaries. She left her for open with the email.
Mm.
Someone went to the email and looked for pause, signing into this seat. You man, you are corrupt, you are stupid, they said.
And even sign out.
Sure.
But you know, some of the things I see, no, somewhere.
Okay. Oh, poor. did they find out?
They find out. You can finish. This is your.
But when we talk about protection, yeah. Security, those are some of the things. Because even you could be here, you're logging onto your library system, and I come and I send something to whoever. And then you cannot say, it's not me. Then the university is put on. is terrible. And those are the techniques that I think they teach people about information security.
Yeah, mm.
Exactly.
So I think we need to work with you and see how much needs to be
done. I was amused.
Either we shall set up the ICT consultant, and then we'll see how to talk about it.
We've always talked about the consult, and Annie used to tell us some percentage you pay to the university, and we never got to understand what she would really mean.
It's a long story, actually. When I just come up with my PhD, I wrote a proposal to start issue ICT consultant.
That would be a good idea.
Yeah, but
she would tell us some percentages. Something
went wrong, which we can discuss. Maybe we can revive it from this committee.
Yeah, it can be revived.
Yeah, maybe. But it's a long story. We can go to our end.
So the next item, management information system. MIS has been going on for. It's also phased. One phase is clear, another one is not yet clear. MIS is a tricky business. But the first phase is coming up with a business requirements for the MIS. I found when the university had already procured a consultant, and we've been working with these ones tirelessly to at least to make sure for what they have been assigned to do, they do it thoroughly. And next week, we are starting a phase of validation. They have to come and show us what they have done. They present to the teams they worked with, and then they agree that, okay, this is a proper presentation of what we told you.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be third, they are meeting academics. Second, they are meeting academics. Fourth, they are meeting the finance team. 15th and 14th, they will meet HR and DOSA. And after, they will meet management, maybe end of the month. And those deliverables will be signed off. Those are the business requirements and the system requirements documents, which are key. And I think the architecture, which are key to the way forward. Now, phase two will be, after we have these documents, what next? And that is where, okay, VC, of course, we shall sit and agree again. VC also requested the consultant to recommend on the way forward. They also deliver like a project management plan that will be also a guide, and most members of management are looking at procuring systems, but another section within UIS, this is maybe off book, is thinking of developing in-house capacity, and then we use these requirements that have been gathered, and then develop the system internally. The section that is looking at that feels that this would be one, cheaper, and also in the long run, maintenance, if it has been developed internally, that means the capacity that we built might in the long run benefit the university. Whenever we have a change to make, we don't have to run again, we do it internally. So, but that has not yet been decided. It is after, right now we are at the point of requirements gathering, and we are now next week going to start validation. That is where we are right now. But after that, the way forward will be to decide, is there a system on the market that is available that can meet these requirements, or can we develop internally, can we build capacity internally, and I think if we went that way, it would come up with such an idea of an ICT consultant, because we would need some expert developers to guide the team. So that's where we are with MIS.
Thank you so much. I know it's about MIS. Not to be actually, because I've been working with MIS. I think the time we have, remember, we can do a support. Long going to generate reports for the population reports, faculty reports, up to Senate. Senate, when you go to Senate, you don't organize. So right now, the management system is at the faculty level. And we think that if you pilot it and people can start using it, maybe they can get some of the feedback. And then the feedback will be the input for the management information system. Or else, the design management system can be complement
yes.
the management information system. And also, we believe that if it's working perfectly, we shall be able to convince the management that we can actually have the in-house complement.
Yes.
Because by getting software from out, we are moving. Because the software has not followed software and principles. Do you know like what they will fail?
Actually, that's what is, has been happening in the past. You know, we gather requirements, but when you go out there to look for a software, there is no software that is already built to the requirements that you've just gathered now. And those are off-shelf softwares. You can't tell some of these companies, okay, now modify this one. You get so most of the time, actually, they expect you to modify your internal processes to work the way the software is used.
Works, yeah.
So that is why things have been failing. So I also personally believe it's better to take this direction of in-house.
I think I totally agree with that. But this is where we started. In 2004, I think, four, five, six, there was a company building software here for UC.
I was at Vastec.
One of those guys.
No, I was at Vastec at the time when Arimus was developed.
Yes.
Now, when I left Vastec, they sold to you the idea that they're building for UCU. You know, when you have a company that's you're not building a product that's going to sell just in one university. You want your product to work in other universities. So they were still building a product for universities. That's what they then really making it specific to UCU wouldn't be good for business.
No.
That's you sell to UCU and you're done. So
it appeared as though
so the, yeah, they make.
They said they were building one for Kumba as well.
It was the same system.
I think they kept on adding up what we couldn't take. They, I think Nkumba was open-minded. They kept on adding in for them, and it's now running. You're right. I was told so. I think I want to agree with the in. Because right from the beginning, we've seen projects from ICIT, from the Faculty of Computing, where really students would develop some nice things, like an online application, wouldn't be still soliciting hard copies from students. But I don't know why management took long to believe that even our little students can
do something.
Yes, because really like an online application form.
Yeah, I mean, imagine
a bachelor's student can develop a system. So you pick that now that there is result management, and then with time, they can be integrated and you come up with something very nice. Yes, exactly. Finance a module at a time, and with time, if you give it time, you get a point and then you integrate and things will be nice. I would also actually really advocate for that.
Actually, in the same regard, maybe just to give you an update, Nkumba is actually now using a system. There is a system that was developed use in-house, like we are saying, in Chambogo, which most universities are using, must. And now Nkumba is actually using that one now. So they also, I don't want to say, I don't know the arrangement they have, they haven't kicked out, the Vastec system didn't work for them as well, eventually.
Eventually it didn't
yes.
work.
But they haven't terminated their contract. They're using a component in that system for a small component, and then they're taking up this new system. They haven't taken up fully the system that MUST and other universities are using. So they're still trying to balance two systems, but slowly eliminating the VASTEC system. It.
But also the challenge, because he has taken up that system.
Even that one of VASTEC.
Which one?
They are using
some system
some
that
system.
Is selling around. So eventually.
Is it a free system? Is it someone selling it?
No, Chambogo did an in-house. They did an in-house system.
Yes.
Chambogo?
Yes.
Could do an in-house thing.
you keep getting surprised. It's about Ndeje. But they
but
built an in-house
bit
system.
By bit. Mm. If you develop
and,
achieve.
Eventually they broke off. They did a company separate, like the idea he was talking about. So there's a separate company that is now in charge of that system.
Okay.
So now they are rolling it out in many universities. But of course, the initial concept was for Chambogo. So when you roll out to another university, of course, that means there are changes required.
Mm.
Yeah, but it has been around for long. So
that's
why.
Does it work for them? Is it working? Because let me tell you, Chambogo is shambles.
I think there are a lot of things that come into play when you're using a system. Like you said, you might have a good website and still doesn't, people still don't.
Yeah.
But the whole idea is when you build in-house, you know what you want and
yeah,
you build
true.
For that. There is nothing that beats that.
Yeah, true that, I agree.
Yeah.
And the Chambogo system was a distressed project. Then some lecturers will pick up, start having it.
Okay. Okay, that's
so
nice.
Our students have skills. Huh?
They do, they do. So I think that's what I'm saying. I think the in-house thing is the way to go. And I hope it works.
But remember, in the last three meetings here, church, I actually recommended that this happens in the house. If we can take our minutes. But we need to have in the house, we both may. We have both modules and modules. I don't know how we stop. Maybe I can put it in the ask.
We need to.
Because I'll use somebody to do it. And we put someone to see the patient. And bring someone away.
These days, management. You see, has been burnt thrice, and a lot of money has gone down the drain. So,
but first, let's keep coming. You know, maybe I'm going to ask money to me. Item number 5, destruction of joint and power land, destruction in public park labs and creation of the bathroom. Maybe Robert will come in here later. But in November, I wrote a letter, actually, it was like a dossier to management. This year, I got all of people management about the status of the laboratory. Specifically, of course.
Okay. Mm.
Because you are still, you have been using for the terminals. Yet the fact that you know the database programming, you need to keep on changing the things. But now the terminals, we have the terminals, but the 60 minutes and whatever they are wireless. So it's really very important that this is stable. So I wrote to management that trying to respond why it is reducing the number of students because of the plastic problem of Calabasas. The visitor was shocked and the order requested this financial by the capacity to look into our problem. Then Calabasas told me and the UIS to summarize the report because it was a very big document. The information I have, I talked to today's finance director agreed actually to have at least 100 computers by the next financial year. But also the problem, we still have a problem actually. We are trying to see the UIs how can we because we have they must give us 100 computers. But that's not enough. The computer our computer lab, many of you possibly will not be there.
I've been there, I know. It's terrible. No, it's not fit to be allowed.
It's not fit to be allowed.
It's not fit. So the question is, if you bring this computer, to the last one. That's actually this one came here. So when we want, I think, to go through this committee, to, we really don't want to do. Will the universe allow to restructure the lab? I think there's a lot of dust putting the computer there and making big problems. Should we relocate those computers from first to this side? But again, it should be problematic. Because the way we're working with Faculty of Science, the way we're designing it to be UIs, we have now opened our lab sort of for our 6 days a week.
Mm.
But now the students are responsible for the labs from 6 up to 9. Although I've been doing this for 2 years, I'm not working so far.
It's good.
The students have been doing very well, they've been reporting, there's no problem so far. So if we move them from that side here, I think it's going to be affected. Mm.
So your students can stay in the lab the whole night working? Good, that's
so
nice.
We work in such a way that the security is covered for that reason.
Mm.
But the students think they are in charge of the lab.
That's good, that's nice.
So if you take this lab here, that's a little bit. So we've been trying to brainstorm with you and try to see how possible. So this way is to force management to do something with the lab, to ensure that the lab are not that free. But I've been also with that come to this committee, and I want to have a recommendation. So the management can look at it, put it in.
Isn't that go to PEEP, the PEEP committee?
The physical
infrastructure and yeah, and preservation committee. That's their job to do that.
So that means I request that let's be in there. Then as I write the letter from planning.
No, I can write it to the physical infrastructure and preservation committee chair. That is Mr. Mgawi.
Oh.
Yeah, he's the chairman. And you table that.
Then I will quote you.
No, I think that is it.
That's something else.
But I think still that committee would also maybe recommend something because they know.
So you might speak.
Telling them we have a lab there, it has a problem, and as we talk about the either renovation or whatever, they will tell us whether the lab should be shifted or whatever to do.
And then I think maybe we need to move fast because Perez seems to have been given a go ahead to identify a location like one of these rooms in the next building.
Oh, yeah,
that can
talk to a bigger lab.
Then the lab will be set up there. But of course, there is that concern he already communicated, I think, to Mr. Mugawi. The faculty is the other side and then managing the lab off-site
is
tricky. So I guess this recommendation would need to move fast.
What you mean?
To look, identify a location,
okay, yeah.
Then for him, he would push.
Mm.
So if he knows that actually the recommendation is to restructure. Because it's actually a big inconvenience, separating a lab from the faculty.
My question is for that room, because you want to go to the room. So they are still beautiful. You take them from there and keep them somewhere here, or computer screen. And that can answer the second. But also, we can go with the data to see how we can.
So you would want the new computers to stay that side?
As the same space is the same building.
The vision of ICT policy. When you say vision, that means we have an ICT policy.
It's out there.
There is one, but revision is a full day.
The ICT policy was approved on April 2012, and yet the renew interview shows it should be reviewed every 3 years. I think that was drafted by Aikasana, Engineer Isaac Kasana.
There was a team, I was part of that team. There was a
Perez was involved, I think, has an idea of this old one, so he would work well with the...
Okay. So we have Rita Perez, Mexico, then the Bosco of Awizi, DBCAA, I think we need to, your office, we need to get some. You send the name after consultation?
All right.
Or yourself? Yeah, you can help us.
It's okay, Lydia Namanya.
So we can get back to you.
So then I need for legal person.
My.
Oh. Policy, but I think I
but also HR, I think DVC F and A. I think they are the custodians of policies.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if
yeah, they are custodians of policies.
Ella might ask.
I assume Mr. Chipola are supposed to come.
Oh, yes, I think
yeah,
he usually caters for that.
So let him be on that committee. So we just need to write to them to start working, providing the ICT committee. The movie went well.
But maybe, could it be in a Bishad, even like maybe it's all of us?
Mm-hmm.
The soft copy, if you can get the soft copy,
yes.
And hand over to them.
Mm-hmm.
You can come up with the chairperson.
Yeah,
who
I need the chair someone to drive it.
Who do you think can chair that?
Maybe Perez.
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 What is the purpose of a meeting? You can push him.
Yeah. That's okay.
But not only should there would be.
But you see, people are not informed. Why are you personally? You need to come. Mm.
I have seen this.
Take a spare part. Exactly. What are the expectations, you know?
So even Docker, I think,
maybe Docker's why it would help because the other items that are coming up. There are specific policies or procedures that UIS is working on. Like, as we work on the DRS solution, we shall have a backup policy. Because right now we do backups based on our IT knowledge, but there needs to be also a guiding policy in that, you know. Then another one we're working on is a change control policy. If my boss comes and says, no, but you uninstall Focus, I'm supposed to listen to him as my boss, but I feel that is not right. It's a big change. There should be a guiding policy for such changes. Okay, maybe I need an approval. He needs to sign somewhere.
That's true.
For such a change, I need to take a backup first. So there is also a change policy that we're working on. There is also an email policy, but now these ones are very detailed. They talk about, for example, a student will have maybe 500 MB space for his email. A staff member can have 1 GB. Those ones go to the detail, which the ICT policy will not. The detail that the ICT policy doesn't go to. Actually, these ones talk about procedures of some things as well. Yeah, actually, these are more like
procedures.
Yes.
Then those can, yeah.
Yeah, maybe so there are procedures, not policies.
Yeah.
No, yes.
So I'm thinking the policy can at some point refer to procedures,
yes.
Like in this case, refer to this procedure, or the procedure would be, if there is need to put it as an appendix, but, well, the policy can remain a bit high level.
Yeah, that's
what you're really yeah. Mm. Okay. Those of them could be operational. Yeah, yes, good. Mm. Then, say after due consultations, this was agreed. Then you force us to, like to have, like to follow that path. If you are telling me to change this, like, no, this is what operational guidelines for this part.
So given the operational guidelines that we are working on, it would be actually important for her to be part of.
Yeah.
And
now,
that means you are going to write to them.
It is this committee.
Responsible for amendments. So what you've done is the right thing. Have a subcommittee to handle. Then you can share the changes later.
Okay.
And if there are changes, then we shall revise and then propose to cabinet.
Okay.
So thank you so much, members. We're going to item number 7, which is UCU hosting the National Conference of Communication. This is very important, members. UCC normally provide funds to host the National Conference on Communication every 2 years. The first conference was held at Makerere, the second was at Ndeje. Last year we are in Barra University. Universities submit letters of intent to host the next conference. So when we were in Barra last year, I submitted a letter. But of course, they have been so much in touch with them. So they came up with guidelines, with the next document. Guidelines that we're supposed to follow when we're hosting this conference. Now, the guidelines. because they say you need to be an academia, you want your thing. And then actually our theme, we are trying to how can we work with leadership? So we're going to this theme from internet. Yes. The theme is bridging the innovation gap between academia and leadership. Bridging the innovation gap between the academia and the industry. So for the team that was submitted to the UCC, they have received it, they said they're going to actually discuss it this week, then they get back to us. But actually they liked it so much because they said, oh, this is interesting. We're being trying to see how can we give industry.
Into academia.
Yes, into academia, so they can work together. So they liked the team and they're going to get back to us. And after that, we are also working on the budget, which we are going to discuss. I'm going to invite all the faculty and departments in the university next week again for the meeting to present the budget we have come up with. It's just the first draft of the budget. But I'm happy that the first budget draft goes up to 130 million. And I had a meeting last week with UCC. And they said, okay, we're still in our budget. I said, okay, we're talking. But also, interesting is I contacted the Turkey Oriental University, and I wanted to be on board. And they said, it's very interesting. I think you can even sponsor some things, and then you can come on board, and we'll talk about forensic science, what it can be.
That would be good. Wow.
So we hope it's going to be a very, very big conference. Because one of the things I got to make a presentation at UCC is because it was unique that single does UCU for the conference. I promised them that as we are making a presentation, we shall have online streaming.
Yeah. They
said, UCU, he said, yes, we have the facility.
Wow, I'm liking it.
Because that, Mark. Please, just a moment. Could Mark join us for a second? Because this is very important. The chairman here just threw us in a furnace and said that we can actually host a live stream. I'm assuming it's not really.
Mm-hmm.
I'm assuming that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah, I'm just going to do that.
Do we have the gadgets to stream live from the
corner?
Chaplaincy.
They stream the service, it's true.
No, listen.
Yeah, because right now this program.
So we should be able to do it. Do we need any more gadgets to think and call you?
All they need is they have their camera and they have I think you have to just select the camera and need for me to stream. So if I don't need to be
business,
I just go in.
Excellent. So we're in business.
But also I want the committee to know is that we budgeted up to 17 million for media. And UCC has accepted that they'll take us to NBA 17 for at least a month, twice, where we talk about the conference and to be an opportunity for us to talk about our courses, about the program we offer here.
That's great.
And that's why NBA is a very short interest to sponsor the conference. We're contacting Venu. Venu is not sponsoring the conference. Venu are looking at sponsoring the conference in the way of giving us bigger bandwidth for the 2 days.
Of course.
For streamlining and giving people the participants to.
Okay, those are easier details. Our furniture.
Now, the conference, the way it's organized.
I have many worries.
The way, I'm going to simplify your work. The way we're going to organize this conference. We are going to have the opening, whatever, in Koyoyo, because Koyoyo can cater for the 400 or 300.
Yes.
Mm.
Then after that, we are going to have a session.
Which is good.
So a lot of the session is going to be here. And this can accommodate up to 30 people.
Yes.
So because we have now innovation gap, ICT, IT, industry, I talked to the dean business, he said I have many papers, I've talked to the dean in Matcom, we said that with the papers. So all they are going to be different. that means we shall need like 5 rooms.
Which is okay.
Different sessions.
Because here you can have, we have one here, there's two there, then there's a smaller room, PowerPoint room.
Which basically now.
Yeah, at least those. No, they, yeah, we can use this, yeah.
Maybe the boy, some can stay there.
Yeah, some can stay there. Yeah, so you have at least 1, 2, 3, 4.
Dining
room. That's too, that's not nice for the presentation. But at least 1, 2, 3, 4 rooms here that can support that. Those smaller spaces, breakaway sessions. But for me, furniture, you see, we have such a fantastic reputation, but still, we still do funny furniture. Even for, yes, I mean, you can see how our master's students study.
Yeah, true.
They study worse than undergraduates. I'm telling you, it's awful. So when we talk about presentation, let me tell you, I hope your budget has chairs.
You will budget, that's what.
Then let's budget for chairs, because we cannot afford to use those funny chairs we have.
Mm.
I'm telling you, we do it, but it's fake. It is so terrible. We render look people. Where you see you, we can't have those funny things.
Can we borrow library chairs?
No, of course not.
For the days?
No.
Maybe we will hire from outside.
No. We need to hire chairs, proper chairs.
Actually, that's why in the next meeting, I'm inviting people from different departments, including security and
engineering.
So that we see it, and then we come up with different committees, and then those committees come up with these budgets.
Maybe you guys might, you could, the chairs use money, you know, and people come.
Some of scratches, you need to first check properly before you sit whether your part of your trousers skirt won't stay there.
So that means that committee, we have to go back to the committee, the DVC expander.
Yeah. No, he knows, but I don't think they'll do anything. So your budget should have.
But either if it doesn't, well, knowing you, see, it may not move as fast. Maybe the hiring.
Oh, we can hire plastic.
The hiring, but plastic would also be over worse.
Because if you say September, this is September 20th and 21st. But there's some chairs in it. That's another breakaway point, actually. Principal's Hall, there are some chairs, library chairs, no, these are old now.
You can borrow for two days.
It's easier to borrow and have a decent setup. You're going to be streaming live, and it's like you're in a funny classroom in which university is this? Umba somewhere in the dark.
So that's the good information I have for this committee.
That's nice.
Yeah,
I like. I'm excited actually about it.
Yeah, actually, it's very interesting. We're going to publish at university. We're giving the app to our Pick 6 registration. The registration talks about the office and our programs and the weather. But now, interesting to note, in fact, I'm a bit stuck. This guy who is the owner of the NBS, the lighting guy.
What is that?
And they were talking actually, he's having a lot of money, the guy in the world, and I think he does, my best wants now is to be known. And I'm thinking that as he becomes, we can present, because I mean, I want to invite him to be one of the key speakers, because I want to be involved. Writing a concept. I don't know if I know that. Because the thing must be known. So if you can put for us a first story building and a lab, I think everything is there.
I mean,
he's willing to do that.
I can give him a space for 10 stories if he wants.
Why not? Because what he wants now is.
Not easy.
Yeah, I know the kind of thing.
Yes, I was going to say, I thought NBS.
Okay, I'm stuck. But that's what you don't support the complex.
If I was management and someone is willing to put the building, me, I will ignore everything.
Management
in terms of.
And building. even if I want it, I cannot compromise that. That one.
But of course,
you but you said he's willing.
Yeah, I'm going to put
it. Please put it down.
Give it a shot.
Give it a shot.
Unless, yes, we do. But let me tell you, the implications are huge.
Yeah, the implications are huge.
So,
you know, it could be silent on the Muslim name.
Yes.
Those are the dynamics we discussed. Khalisa building.